Now I'm sitting in a car that I won't start. Maybe I got too much to say right now. Like I'm paralyzed from the waist down.
All right, you guys, so it is the night before surgery. It's like 9:15, almost 9:30. I can't eat anymore past midnight nor drink anything, so I'm trying to eat and drink everything that I can before I go to sleep, because my surgery is at noon tomorrow, so I can't eat anything up until noon. So I'm gonna try to get everything out before I go to sleep, because I don't know if it happens to anybody else, but I get cotton mouth like in the middle of the night where I have to wake up and drink something. I can't drink anything. And then I do drink coffee in the morning to wake myself up. So this is going to be a challenge for me, you guys, but we're gonna go over the things that I bought for my surgery. So without further ado, let's get right into it, you guys. So my doctor went ahead and got me all of my prescriptions. So you guys, I have something that is close to volume. I guess it's for nausea, muscle spasms, all of that great stuff. I also got hydrocodone as well, for pain. I also got promethazine as well, and I got a Z-Pak. I also have this patch that goes behind my ear. I already have it on. You're supposed to put it on the night before surgery. I also got an ice bag for my boobs to help with the swelling for tomorrow. I did end up getting like actual ice packs. You guys, I got two sets of ice packs. So I got cold packs here. I got these from Target, and then disregard that. I got an ice bag so that I can put ice on it, because I only got two of these, one for each boob, but I don't know how long they last. So I want to make sure that I have something at all times where I'm not taking a set of peas out the freezer and sitting them on my chest, because y'all know I'm not gonna be able to move. So I'm gonna have to rely on somebody else to put them back in the freezer and not let them spoil. The next thing that I got, you guys, is extra strength Tylenol, because I do not plan on taking all of the hydrocodone at all. I do not like taking those type of medicine or getting dependent on them as well. The next thing that I got is one of these little pillows to go behind my head, because if you guys do not know, I am a stomach sleeper, so this is going to be very hard for me to try to sleep on my back. If I'm not sleeping on my stomach, I normally wake up on my side, but for the most part, I'm a stomach sleeper, so this is going to be hard for me to start off with. So I did end up going to Walmart. I had to go to three different Walmarts, two different Targets, to find stuff for my surgery. Now they tell you to make sure that you wear something that can zip down in the front. So I could not find anything on in my size, because I wear a small and all the smalls were sold out. So I had to get this color and something that zips all the way down. I've already scheduled my pre-op. My pre-op is on Thursday at 9 a.m. They also said wear some baggy pants, no leggings or anything, no biker shorts. So I do have my Pretty Little Things sweatpants. They are in a size 8. So these are going to be real scratchy. And then I do have three different surgical bras, you guys. I have a black one, and this is the brand that I got. I got it from Walmart. What I'm going to do is I'm probably going to wear this one, and it's in a small. I'm going to take the padding out. I do have an actual surgical bra where they have like the adjustable straps on the shoulders and the adjustable straps on the front, but I wanted to wear something that I was able to zip up and not have to like button up. I also got one of these as well, same brand, just a different color. I'm gonna wear the black one, because what I witnessed on YouTube is a lot of ladies do experience a little bit of bleeding. I'll probably wear this one once I'm like a week or two post-op, once they take my stitches out. I also end up getting the Arnica gel, Arnica Care gel. I saw this on a lot of YouTube videos saying that this helps with recovery. I could not find the Arnica tea, but I will be buying that. I also have the Opti recovery pills coming that helps with, you know, surgery like this, but you can only get that on Amazon. If I knew about it sooner, I probably would have bought it. Where I found out about the Opti recovery was through a Facebook group that I'm in for Jolie Plastic Surgery. I was originally going to go with Jolie Plastic Surgery, but I do not like those people at all. So, I end up going with somebody locally here. So, last few things that I got while I was out, you guys. So I end up getting like a lot of stuff with pineapple juice because they said that really helps. So I got like fruits that have pineapple juice in them. I have already chicken noodle soup. I already have like Jell-Os. I already have puddings. My mom will be with me for like the first 2 days, so I should be fine. I also got Gatorades. Gotta stay hydrated on top of water. So I have about 5 Gatorades, 2 that look like this, and then 2 bigger ones. So I'm only gonna try my best to be down for like maybe 3 days at the most. I am getting my surgery on a Wednesday. My post-op is on a Thursday. All right, you guys. So my camera had died, so I had to re-record this video. So let's get right into it. We're gonna get into pricing. A lot of people think that, oh, you know, my surgery's $3,000. That's all I need to have. No, you need to have a lot more when it comes to your surgery. And what I mean is, you can say, okay, my surgery is $3,000, but you don't account for your prescription. You don't account for your labs. You don't account for if you have to have a physical exam or a clearance from a physician before you are able to get surgery. Luckily, I didn't have to do that because the surgery center that I'm going to, they only require physical exams for people that are over 50 years old that are getting plastic surgery. You do have to also account for aftercare and, you know, your surgical garment or clothes that you did not have prior to. So it's not always going to be just $3,000 flat or, you know, $5,000 flat, whatever your doctor quoted you, because that may be your price because you live in that city. But just imagine if you were going out of the state, to a different state. You had to account for Uber, you have to account for your lifts and, you know, your Airbnbs, your recovery house, you have to account for your massage, you got to account for food, you got to account for any extra massages or anything that you might have going on. You need to bring extra money too. So let me go over everything that I end up paying, you guys. I ended up paying, originally I was going with saline implants, but because your girl is really clumsy, I do not want to fall and bust my implants, baby. That just one for me. And then everyone that I know that I've talked to that has saline implants, which I know a couple of women, they say that they're very hard. And I do not want anything hard in my body. Like my boobs are, I may look like a pigeon by the chest, baby, but at least my boobies are soft. So I want to keep it that way. So I waited till I ended up getting paid. The difference for me to get silicone implants was $750. So I ended up paying $4,500 for my surgery for a saline implants. However, I ended up paying an extra $750 for silicone, and then I ended up getting the Bliss Care. I'll have to go over that in a separate video, but Bliss Care is for the first year you have insurance on your breast. Say you keloid or you get a capsule contraction or whatever that is that makes your boob hard and in place with the scar tissue, they are able to go in and fix that and it won't cost you anything. I also got changed to silicone because they do have a great warranty on your implants. So I really wanted that. So all together, you guys, I ended up paying about $5,800 for my surgery, or $56 maybe, because it was what, $4,500, then I paid $750. So yeah, about $5,600 I'm ending up paying for my surgery, and that is not accounting for my medicine. I had to pay around $35 for my medicine, for all of the prescriptions that I explained to you guys earlier. I also pay another like $65 for all of my aftercare wear, my surgery outfit. I end up paying like $15 for the little neck pillow. I ended up buying some aftercare stuff, which equals up to like $20. And then I ended up buying some food as well, which also costed me another like $20. So all together, you guys, I would say about $5,800 that I'm ending up paying for my surgery. The doctor that I'm going with is Christopher Schaefer. He's in Birmingham, Alabama. And he's been doing it for a while. He's an older doctor. Now, the reason why I originally picked him, you guys, I was supposed to be going to head and plastic surgery, but they did not have any consultation dates until April, and I wanted to go ahead and get it done because I'm working from home. My mother's currently out because she broke her wrist, so there's a good chance that she can take care of me for the most part. So she's off. This will be the perfect time for me to be getting a surgery. So I decided to go ahead, try to get the surgery as soon as possible. So I kept calling up the head and plastic surgeon. Like, do y'all have any cancellations? Do y'all have the cancellations? Do y'all have the cancellations? Originally, you guys, 2 years ago, I was supposed to get my breast done. I paid my $4,000 and I was going to be done. I was getting silicone. I was going to have Dr. Gunn at head and plastic surgery do my surgery, but I ended up backing out because I did do my research on breast implant illness, and it does not apply to everybody, but that did scare me to death, and I was like, no, I'm just gonna wait till I do a little bit more research. So now here it is 2 years later, and I still want to get them done. So, you know, gotta take the chance. So I'm gonna go ahead, you know, take my chance. So, went to my consultation at Christopher Schaefer. The consultation fee was zero. Head and plastic surgery is zero. I ended up going, staying there maybe like an hour. The doctor was very knowledgeable. I had a million questions. He checked me out. I normally thought that my right boob was smaller than my left boob, but he ended up saying that for the most part they're pretty symmetrical, so I'm going to get the same size implants. Originally, I was going to get saline. I was going to get 390 cc's. They was going to give me a 360 capsule, like silicone capsule, and they were going to fill it over the limit to 390. I am getting moderate profile. However, I did change the silicone today, last minute, and I'm getting a 385. So 5 cc's less than what I was supposed to get. I wanted high profile, but because of the diameter, the measurements from this side of my boob to the other side, each implant is a different measurement as far as, I would say, width. So they do it based on the width of your existing breast. So most women will get high profile, but because I'm small frame, I guess they wanted a more narrow implant because I don't have a lot up top, but whatever. So moderate profile is what I'm getting. I am in a surgery group asking ladies about everything. So tomorrow I will not most likely be working. If I do work, I will be working up until the time that my surgery is, and I will not be working the following day. I will be working from home for like the following 2 weeks because I can't drive anywhere. But like they said, everybody's recovery is going to be completely different. I am going to try to vlog this entire experience, so it will be a second video, but I did want to let you guys know. So now I'm getting ready to hop in the shower. I already have my patch on. It's supposed to help me with nausea after my surgery because the lady did help me and let me know that, hey, a lot of women do feel nauseous right after they come out of surgery when they're in recovery because of the anesthesia and the tube that goes in their mouth to make sure that they're breathing. So I went ahead and put it on the night before like I was supposed to, and I think I should be good. I do want to thank the process for being so easy, you guys. Originally, my surgery date was supposed to be March the 22nd. When I first went in, I was trying to get March 19th, but once I called back later, she was like, somebody already got that surgery date, so you're not going to be able to get that surgery date, so you can move to the 22nd, or you can try to go in for the 3rd. I was like, okay, I want to go ahead and get it done before something happens where I back out like I've done multiple times before. So I was like, go ahead, give me like the soonest date, which was that following Wednesday. So I went in on Friday. I'm getting my surgery on Wednesday, which is literally Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, 5 days later. So I had to make sure that everything went good with my financing company, and now I'm good to go and I'm cleared. I literally went to pre-op. All I had to do was take a COVID test. I had to give myself my COVID test, and I did have to go get my labs done. I literally went across the street to the Grandview Hospital, and I went to the Physicians Plaza on the second floor, and I ended up getting my labs. The labs took literally 5 minutes. They literally stick you in your arm and they take 3 tubes of blood and then you leave. At that point, that's it. When you are doing your pre-op, they ask you questions about, do you smoke, do you drink, do you have any health problems, are you allergic to anything, and then they proceed to hand you a little swab. It has like a little bristle on the end and it's kind of curved, and they make you do your own COVID test. I didn't think that I did mine right, but I guess I did mine right. But honey, that was so uncomfortable, like for real. I thought they were gonna have to prick my finger and do it that way, but they decided not to do it that way, let alone do it by the mouth. So hopefully I won't have to do another COVID test when I go in. But yeah, you guys, that is it for my experience right now. Overall, I'm so pleased. Sarah, my coordinator, is on top of it. She was amazing. Every time I called, I would call up there every few hours, honey, like, hey, I'm working on it. Hey, I'm gonna be late to my pre-op. They messing around. And she was very, you know, patient with me. Like, honey, if somebody was calling 10 times a fucking day, I would be annoyed too. So she was amazing. I would recommend Schaefer Plastic Surgery to anybody. He's amazing. He's great. So they did let me know that my surgery literally might take 30 to 45 minutes. I will go in at noon and my mom will drop me off. She will then come back to my home, which I literally stay right around the corner from the plastic surgery center. And she'll have to come back and get me at like 3:30. So I'm ready to go ahead and get it over with, honey, because these chichis are gonna look lit. And I'm so happy that I decided to go with silicone, and I'm so glad that I paid that extra money because it gives me a peace of mind. Yes, saline sounds more safe because of the saline water, and you know, if it busts, you'll know. But at the same time, you do want to keep in mind that if it busts, you're gonna be walking around here with one flat boob, and I just don't see myself wanting to do that at all. So because everybody just don't have money to just be going out here and getting a boob fix all of a sudden, or having to get a whole new set of titties. And then what I also talked to her about was, hey, you know, what if I don't like my saline and I want to get silicone? She's like, well, you're going to have to pay a whole new price, a whole another $5,000 to get silicone. And she's like, why not just wait and get silicone? I'm like, fuck no. Like, girl, I want to go and get this over with. So thank God my check came in today, and I was able to go ahead and switch to silicone in time. And I'm getting what I want because it was only $750 difference. I would rather pay $750 compared to paying another $5,000 in 2 years. So I'm happy with that. But the doctor, he did let me know that, hey, some women don't even get their implants changed. The motto that they have there is, why break it if it's not, why fix it if it's not broken? So some women can have to change their implants, some don't. They recommend it, but I guess you don't have to. But that's not something that he recommends to me. He did just bring that up. So to each everybody's own. But I really enjoyed the doctor. He was very knowledgeable and he answered any questions, and he gave me step by step of what profiles mean and everything. Make sure that you are comfortable with your doctor. Price does not matter. You need to trust the person that's getting ready to cut into you. But with that being said, you guys, thank you guys for watching. I will see you guys tomorrow before my surgery, and I will see you guys on my 1 day post-op and at my post-op appointment. So yeah, you guys have a wonderful day, and I will see y'all tomorrow.